Hello everyone, I'm Fuda. I am back with another video on cooking time. Today I'm making cream cheese apple rose tarts. I posted a picture of the tarts yesterday on Instagram and somebody said make them. So why not? So let's get right into this. For this recipe, you're going to need sugar. It says use 3 tablespoons of sugar, but you just pour it on with a spoon or this, so you don't have to measure that out. Just cinnamon, there's no specific amount. 1 to 2 sheets of crescent roll dough, or just puff pastry dough. 1 apple. 3 tablespoons of water. 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. And 1/4 cup of room temperature cream cheese. So, let's start cooking. Okay, so now, first we're gonna cut off the apple. I can take some, you know what? We're gonna cut up the apple, and I have a paper towel here to get your apple pieces. I lost my knife. You're gonna make the apple slices super thin, so it'll look good in the rose. But first off, you just cut it in half. That worked. Forgot a spoon. Welcome to my channel where I forget everything. Okay, so then you just core out the apple, which actually can be a pain, but it's not that hard. Your apple should look somewhat similar to mine. Now I'm gonna show you how to cut the apple. So with this little end rugged part, you just cut that off. You don't want to waste any apple here because you have a lot. You have four roses. You're gonna need a lot of apples, and you just cut it super thinly. Like, honestly, this is about good. This thinness, maybe even a little bit thinner. And you just put it. Oh, you chuck it in a bowl. You just take your bowl. This is watching my basketball.
So ballin'.
Both pieces are fully cut. Now that the apples are done being cut up, you're going to take 3 tablespoons of water, pour it in there, and your lemon juice. I'm not sure if this is going to cover all 4 sheets. Oh, and move this around. Be very careful because the apples could break easily. And be also careful when they're in the microwave. Speaking about that, put it in the microwave for 3 minutes. Now, while that's in the microwave over there, you're going to make an ice bath in your sink. Wrong way. I'm gonna do a quick little ice bath. The apples are done in the microwave. Pull them out with a towel because it's very hot. And you should see that they're very translucent looking. All my water drained out. You get a paper towel and you pat them dry. Ow. This hurts. Be very careful also because number one, it's hot. Number two, apples can break easily. And it may not look like you have a lot of apples, but you do. Don't worry. Pat this dry. And on the next step. Now, it's time for the puff. You're going to do what it says to open it up. Okay, so this is all rolled out. You can see it's not very even, and then there's a hole right there. You just pinch those holes together. Get your rolling pin and roll this on out. I'm an idiot. Don't put your flour away. You need it. Ow, it hurt. Okay, just Put some more flour on top of your dough. And some on your rolling pin. In the long run, it'll just make it much easier to roll out and deal with. So just roll out. It's stuck. Now you're gonna need your crème chaise, which I need something to spread it with because you know I forget everything on this channel. Cut it very lightly into fourths. Now you take your cream cheese, and it's still not put the room temperature, but you can just squeeze it a little bit, then take a little bit, flop it down on there, and spread. Don't spread too hard or your dough will come apart. Now take your sugar, not the same sugar, no. You just pour it along the side of each one. You can do as much or as little sugar as you like. My dad wanted more sugar, so I'm putting a tiny bit more sugar than I normally would. And boom. Now, you need your apples. I have the apples. So now, with each apple, you start to push it a little bit. Start with it on this end. For this demonstration, I'm just going to start on this end. And you just leave it like that, right at the edge. And this apple has to overlap the edge a little bit. So it creates that, create that nice rose effect. Here's a bigger apple, so it'll look better. And boom. And for this, you just do it with each one, overlapping the apples too. And with each one, with all the apples that you have. And yeah, that's it. I'll see you for the next part. Voila. It's absolutely beautiful. And get your oven preheated at 375 degrees. I'm gonna finish the rest of these apples and I'll show you how long to cook it for and where what to put the apple roses in. So, see you then. These are all rolled up beautifully. Now, take a muffin tin. Get some Pam or oil spray or something. Just spray it in. Not completely, but it's fine. Then you take your roses, put them in each of the four slots that you put them in. Each of the four slots that you pan. And put it in a 375 degree oven for 40 minutes. And then come on back to it and boom, they're basically done, but then there's one more step. So, see you when these are done. Finally, after 40 minutes of waiting, these are finally done. So I'm just gonna pull these on out, lift this up, get some powdered sugar, and strainer? Is that what it's called? I don't know. Duster? Fine strainer? The dusty thing is what I'm calling it. This one turned out a little lopsided. So we got the lop rose. This one is the shorty. So we got the shorty rose. This one came out almost beautifully. So we got just the rose. This one came out crispy, so it's got the crispy rouge. So now I'm gonna push this to the side. And then you just do a nice dusting of powdered sugar on each of them. Or confectioner sugar, the exact same thing. So, after...
That's very good. It's very good. What would you rate it out of 10? It's my kind of dessert. So I rate it a 10.
I rate it a 9.
Point. Perfect for me.
Well, that's it for this video. We've got powdered sugar everywhere over here. Please like and subscribe if you want more cooking videos on my channel. I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.